Toyota has made a risky move that may fundamentally alter the future of automobiles. The company has unveiled a novel water-powered engine that is threatening the market domination of electric cars. Though electric vehicles have been heralded as the clean energy wave of the future, Toyota's cutting-edge technology goes one step further, providing a solution that's both environmentally friendly and more useful and effective. Wouldn't it be lovely to live in a world where you could pump your car with water and head out? Well, that's a concept that could soon become a reality, thanks to Toyota's vision. So stay tuned to learn all about Toyota's latest innovation. Toyota's revolutionary water engine. The Toyota water engine is a technical marvel that has the potential to completely change the car industry. The primary fuel supply for this engine is water, which is something that had never gotten much mainstream traction. In contrast to conventional engines that depend on fossil fuels or electric cars that require extended charging times, Toyota's water engine uses a sophisticated electrolysis technique to separate hydrogen from water. Using an electric current, this process called electrolysis breaks down water, H2O, into constituent components, oxygen and hydrogen. The water molecules are broken down inside the car using an electrolyzer. Two electrodes submerged in water receive electricity, separating hydrogen and oxygen atoms. After that, the hydrogen is kept in a unique tank made to withstand high pressure securely. This stored hydrogen is injected into a fuel cell when the time comes to power the vehicle, where it reacts chemically with airborne oxygen. The car's motor is powered by the electricity produced by this process. This entire process produces just water vapor as a byproduct, making it a very clean and environmentally friendly way to generate energy for the car. Lithium-ion batteries are essential to electric vehicles, EVs, but their production requires significant resources and necessitates lengthy charging periods. In addition, there are serious environmental problems associated with the disposal of these batteries. Toyota's water-powered engine, on the other hand, does away with the requirement for big batteries in favor of hydrogen fuel. Because of this, Toyota's strategy is possibly more economical in the long term, in addition to being more sustainable. Moreover, the water engine provides a degree of convenience that electric vehicles find difficult to equal. Refueling an electric car can take hours, but refueling a hydrogen-powered vehicle simply takes a few minutes, much like filling up a regular petrol tank. Toyota's water engine solves the problem of long-distance travel, which is now a drawback for many electric vehicles, thanks to its quick refilling capabilities. Another significant problem that Toyota's water engine solves is range anxiety. Because hydrogen fuel cells store more energy than lithium-ion batteries do, they can run for longer periods of time due to their higher energy density. Because of this, the water engine is not only highly useful for daily usage, but also very environmentally beneficial. Toyota has created a groundbreaking water engine that combines state-of-the-art technology and practical convenience, suggesting that it might be the next significant step towards completely sustainable transportation. The history of water-powered vehicles. Water-powered vehicles have long piqued the interest of manufacturers and innovators, and many attempts have been made to realize this notion. Stanley Meyer was among the first and most contentious people in this field. Meyer claimed to have created a water fuel cell in the 1980s that could convert water into hydrogen and oxygen with little energy, enabling automobiles to operate only on water. He apparently used this technique to power a dune buggy in his presentations, which attracted a lot of interest from the general public. Nevertheless, Meyer never offered verifiable scientific evidence to support his assertions. And upon closer inspection, his technology proved to be inadequate. Experts pointed out that his water fuel cell design contradicted basic physics rules, particularly the conservation of energy, leading to his conviction for fraud in 1996. Going further, in 2002, a business by the name of Genesis World Energy said that it possessed a machine that could effectively harvest energy from water. It was claimed that their invention, dubbed the Edison device, could change water into a fuel-grade form of hydrogen. The business raised millions of dollars and attracted investors' attention quickly. They never provided a functional model, and their assertions were subsequently written off as a hoax. The proprietor of the business, Patrick Kelly, was eventually convicted of fraud, which raised even more questions about the viability of water-powered cars at the time. A noteworthy attempt was made in 2008 by the Japanese business JPX. JPX said that they had created a vehicle that could operate only on water. The vehicle's release stated that water was separated into hydrogen and oxygen using an onboard mechanism, with the hydrogen being utilized to power the engine. A lot of excitement was generated by the idea of a less expensive and more environmentally friendly fuel substitute. But when specialists saw that JPX's technology also needed a unique metal hydride to speed up the process, doubts spread. This meant that the automobile was not really powered by water. Rather, it was just another hydrogen fuel technology that required other elements to produce hydrogen. One thing unites these unsuccessful attempts. They frequently ignored important scientific principles in favor of overpromising and underdelivering. Water's molecular bonds must be broken with a great deal of energy for it to function as a direct fuel source. The rules of thermodynamics state that you can't extract more energy from water than what you put in to split it. So, although the concept of water-powered cars has captured popular interest, previous attempts to develop them have frequently failed because of a lack of scientific viability. However, Toyota's current strategy, which emphasizes hydrogen produced from water, could at last offer a respectable way ahead. But there may be possible suppression of such technology. Possible suppression of water-powered technology. Though it has the potential to completely transform the energy and automobile sectors, the concept of water-powered technology has been faced with opposition and skepticism for decades. The enormous disruption that such technology would cause is one factor contributing to this opposition. Companies that produce fossil fuels, which now control the majority of the world's energy supply, would suffer greatly if a water-powered engine or any alternative gained traction. These businesses have enormous financial and political clout and are firmly established in international economies. To preserve their market share and earnings, they have a stake in keeping things as they are. They may thus be working to prevent the adoption of alternative energy technology, such as water-powered engines, by campaigning against them. The interests of the market are also quite important. The current gasoline and diesel vehicle infrastructure, which consists of supply chains, fueling stations, and refineries, has been built at a cost of billions of dollars. A quick switch to water-powered engines would make most of this infrastructure non-functional. The economic problems for governments, automakers, and other fossil fuel-dependent businesses would be immense. The advancement of water-powered technologies has been further impeded by hostility from people with financial interests in conventional energy sources because of the possibility of instability. Fear and false information also impede the adoption of water-powered motors. The idea of such technology has been clouded by several prior attempts that were linked to fraud and pseudoscience. Skeptics have been stoked by individuals such as Stanley Meyer, who in the 1980s claimed to have created a water-powered automobile but was unable to produce any scientific evidence. Even when contemporary businesses like Toyota investigate technically sound ways to use hydrogen produced from water as fuel, this distrust endures. Water-powered technology is often associated with scams and failures, which has made it simple for doubters to write off any new advancements, no matter how legitimate they may be. Misinformation campaigns can also increase public mistrust and anxiety. Companies that profit from fossil fuels and other special interests have the means to shape public perceptions of emerging technology. They might sow doubt by highlighting the supposed risks or security issues associated with water-powered engines, such as the hazards associated with producing and storing hydrogen. Because of this, the public is less inclined to demand or support the development of vehicles powered by water. People may choose familiar technology over potentially disruptive ones out of fear of change and a lack of clear information. In spite of these obstacles, companies like Toyota are moving on with research into water-powered technologies and hydrogen fuel cells. Their participation might aid in overcoming opposition by offering workable, scientifically supported answers. But it will take time and public education to overcome the disinformation, vested interests, and skepticism that have historically hampered water-powered technologies. Also leading the world's drive toward more environmentally friendly transportation are China and the United States, who are now the leaders in EV manufacturing. China has adopted a proactive stance, enacting laws and making significant investments in EV infrastructure. Due to the success of businesses like BYD, NIO and XPeng, China is now the world's largest market for electric vehicles. Millions of electric cars are sold each year as a consequence of tight rules that support the government's goal of lowering carbon emissions and urban pollution. In the meanwhile, the United States is the home to market leaders like Tesla, whose groundbreaking designs, state-of-the-art engineering, and vast supercharger network have completely transformed the sector. Now, while these players may seem interested in a water-powered engine, there is so much at stake, so it may take a while before this goal is realized. Now, what do you think of Toyota's groundbreaking water-powered engine? Is this the turning point that puts an end to the age of electric cars? Write your thoughts in the comments section below. Please subscribe to our channel and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Until next time, stay curious.